Welcome to How to Set Up Zoom for Parents and Students. Before your lesson starts, make sure to download Zoom app on your mobile phone, your tablet, or your computer. If you're on a mobile phone or a tablet, this is an example of me downloading it on my iPad just like you would any other application. Once it is downloaded, this is the screen that you will see pop up when you click the app. If you are looking to download onto your computer the Zoom app, go to zoom.us/download and you will be able to have the app on your computer. Once you do have the app, this is the screen that you will see once it's on your computer. You can also always go to zoom.us and click join a meeting. And if for some reason you are unable to download the Zoom app to your computer, you can always open it onto your browser. So that would mean clicking no, and then finally going to the small link that says click here if it's not launching the app, and then it will actually let you join from browser. Another tip that we definitely want to do before the lesson starts is test our technology. Make sure our internet connection is strong and we are ready to start. In order to test this before your lesson starts, make sure to go to zoom.us/test and then click the join button and open the Zoom app and let it launch. Again, this is where you'll be able to click join in browser if for some reason you do not have the app on your computer. And that once it's connecting, you will be auto-logged in and you will see the Zoom room experience. Here's where you can test your microphone, mute and unmute, look at the audio settings, make sure the right microphone and speaker is connected, click test speaker and microphone and actually listen for the ringtone, and then test your microphone to make sure that you can speak and pause and hear the replay. If everything looks good, that is excellent. That means it's all connected. You can also check your video camera if you have one and start and stop the video to make sure it works. Hooray! It's time to finally join the class. Right before it starts, we want to make sure we have our login code that your teacher should have sent you. Copy and paste that code and input it into the join a meeting space. Click join. That should help you get logged in, and you can click open Zoom US to launch the app on browser. On the app, you can just copy and paste again, type in the same code. There is also the option to change your name. So if you're on your parents' iPad, maybe change it to the student's name, and then also to input your meeting ID right after. If you do not see the option to change your name before you log in, no big deal. Once you get into the app, you can just click your name and participants, click rename and rename it to whichever name you would like to be labeled as. You may see this screen when you go to log in. It says, please wait for the host to start the meeting. No worries, that just means that your teacher has not signed on yet. Once they are signed on, you will be able to log into the classroom. In Zoom, there is a chat feature, and your teacher does have the option to turn on and off chat depending on if they want you to be using it during the lesson. Keep in mind, the chat can be distracting for other learners, so please make sure to only use the chat function when the teacher has requested, asked a question, or encouraged you to engage with the chat. To access the chat, click Participants, then click Chat, and you have the option to send a message to everyone in the chat room, in the Zoom room, classroom, or to just choose to send a message specifically to your teacher. So you'll click where it says everyone and instead click the teacher's name, and then you can send a message that will only be private to the teacher. You also have options to raise and lower your hand, answer yes, answer no, ask the teacher to go slower or faster, clap for someone, and also give them a thumbs up, thumbs down, and put the away if you need to step away from the computer. So different buttons that you can click, which are all very helpful when engaging in the classroom. There's also different views if you want a gallery view to see the teacher and see the rest of the classmates. That is also an option as well. The very last tip I want to share with you today is what to do if a teacher asks you to share your screen, what you are working on during the class. So if that happens, It is very simple. You are going to click the button that says share content, go down to whiteboard or whatever part of the screen you want to share. On the whiteboard, you will be able to pick the color of your pen, the thickness or thinness of the pencil you want to use. And then you can go ahead and draw if you're doing a math problem and sharing your work. You can also type if you need to type as well. That is also there for you. You will need the teacher's permission or the teacher to ask you to do this before you just go and share your screen. But this is a good way for you to get an idea of what that would look like. Thank you so much for joining us for how to set up your Zoom for parents and kids. If you want to learn more, check out Scattered Solutions, www.scattered.solutions. We are an online education service platform. And if you found this video helpful, please subscribe, like, share, so that we can continue to put out some more helpful resources.